Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. And a very warm welcome to this live broadcast from St. Peter's Square of the recitation of the Sunday Angelus with Pope Francis. Today, Sunday the 19th of February, as we celebrate the 7th Sunday of Ordinary Time. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to welcome you warmly to this broadcast, and some of you may be joining us through various channels associated with Vatican Media, such as the Vatican Audio Live Events app, the Radio Vaticana app, the Vatican News website, or the Vatican News English YouTube channel or Facebook live feed. To all of you joining us through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks USA, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Radio Maria England, Shalom TV India, Atma Darshan TV, Luminous Radio, and indeed as well as through other radio stations and internet sites throughout the world, a very warm welcome to you all. My name is Ben Sinclair, and it's a pleasure to provide you with the English language commentary for today's Angelus address. We're now seeing pictures of the camera focused on the Apostolic Palace, where in just a few moments the Holy Father will give his weekly Angelus address to the people present. We can see that there is a large crowd present in St. Peter's Square this Sunday, with pilgrims from all over the world. We see people with the Spanish flag, we've also seen the Portuguese flag, and of course the Ukrainian flag as well. And yesterday, on Saturday, Pope Francis sent a message to a study day on people with disabilities, urging everyone to love and care for them, just as Jesus does. He expressed his great pleasure to greet the beautiful initiative and reflected on the word siblings. He explained that a sibling is like a person whose life has forced to be a Cyrenaean, and the strength of roads travelled by this Cyrenaean brother, and reminding us all that God loves us just as we are. And after the terrible earthquake which has affected the countries of Turkey and Syria, Cardinal Konrad Korjewski, the prefect of the Dicastery for the Service of Charity, also known as the Papal Almoner, has told the people of the Holy See's commitment to those suffering from the catastrophic earthquakes. Cardinal Krzyzewski said that there have been immediate assistance that has been provided to those who have been affected and displaced by the terrible earthquakes affecting the two countries. And at the same time, the prefect of the Dicastery for the Oriental Churches, Archbishop Claudio Gugerotti, has also begun his mission among the earthquake victims in Syria. And yesterday, the Holy Father, Pope Francis, has also taken 10 questions, which bring together the 10 years of his pontificate, on a program aired on Italian television entitled Journeys of the Heart. The interview began with a topic close to the Pope's heart, the topic of memory, and the Pope Francis explained that it is a grace to cultivate memory. And there have been very significant places linked to memory and people which have marked our lives. We now see the arrival of the Holy Father to the window of the Apostolic Palace, and he now comes and waves and sends his greeting to all the pilgrims and locals present at St. Peter's Square, and we will shortly begin his weekly Angelus address.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno.
The
words Jesus addresses to us in this Sunday's Gospel are demanding, and they seem paradoxical. He invites us to turn the other cheek and to love even our enemies. It's normal for us to love those who love us, and to be friends of those who are friends to us. But Jesus provokes us by saying, if you act in this way, what more are you doing than others? What more are you doing? Here is the point to which I would like to draw your attention. What more are you doing? This is what I would like to say. More, extraordinary, is what goes beyond the limits of the usual, what exceeds the habitual practices and normal calculations dictated by prudence. Instead, in general, we try to have everything more or less in order and under control, so as to correspond to our expectations, fearing not to receive reciprocation or to expose ourselves too much and then be disappointed. We prefer to love only those who love us, to avoid illusions, to do good only to those who are good to us, to be generous only to those who can return the favor, and to those who treat us badly, we respond in kind. But the Lord warns us, this is not enough. This is not being a Christian. If we remain in the ordinary, in the balance between giving and receiving, things do not change. If God were to follow this logic, we would have no hope of salvation. But fortunately for us, God's love is always extraordinary. It goes beyond the usual criteria by which us humans live out our relationships. Jesus' words challenge us then, while we try to remain within the ordinary of utilitarian reasoning. He asks us to open ourselves up to the extraordinary, the extraordinary of a freely given love. While we always try to balance the books, Christ encourages us to live the unbalance of love.
Non è un bravo ragioniere. No, sempre va allo sbilanciamento dell'amore.
Jesus always talks about the challenge of love, the unbalance of love. And we should not be surprised at this. If God had not unbalanced himself, we would never have been saved. It's the unbalance of the cross which has saved us. Jesus would not have come to seek us out when we were lost and distant. He would not have loved us right up until the end. He would not have embraced the cross for us, who did not deserve all this and could not give him anything in return. As the Apostle Paul writes, you could hardly find anyone ready to die for someone upright, though it is possible that, for a really good person, someone might undertake to die. So it is proof of God's own love for us, that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. So, God loves us while we are sinners, not because we are good or able to give something back to him. Brothers and sisters, God's love is a love always in excess. It always goes beyond calculation. It's always disproportionate. And today, he also asks us to live in this way, because only in this way we will truly bear witness to him. Brothers and sisters, the Lord invites us to step out of the logic of self-interest and to not measure love on the scales of calculations and convenience. He invites us not to respond to evil with evil, to venture in the good, to risk in the gift, even if we receive little or nothing in return. For it is this love that slowly transforms conflicts, shortens distances, overcomes enmities, and heals the wounds of hatred. And so, we can ask ourselves, do I, every one of us, do I, in my life, follow the logic of recompense or that of gratuitousness? The extraordinary love of Christ is not easy, but it is possible. It is possible. because he himself helps us by giving us his Spirit, his love without measure. And let us pray to Our Lady, who by answering yes to God without calculation, allowed him to make her the masterpiece of his grace.
Et concedi lo Spirito Santo.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedicto frutto venti tu, Gesù.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus e benedicto frutto venti tu, Jesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus e benedicto frutto venti tu, Jesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Grazie a Tu, Anquessum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, che Angelus Nuntiante, Christi Fili Tui, Incarnazione Cognovim, per passione meius et crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum Nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defunctis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua luce a teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Gloriam nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit celum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen. Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, the love of Jesus asks us to leave everything. I think especially for Syria and Turkey, to the many victims of the earthquake, but also, I think, to the dear population of Ukraine and all of the many peoples who are suffering from war and motives of poverty and the lack of freedom and the environmental issues. There are many people. I am close in the same sense to New Zealand, hit by a cyclone in the last few days. Dear brothers and sisters, let us not forget those who suffer, and let's make sure that our charity is concrete and we're attentive to the people who are suffering. I greet all of you who have come from Italy and other countries. I greet the pilgrims from Oviedo in Spain, the students from Portugal. I greet the group from Rimini. A group of Catholic people from Rimini, from Catholic Action, from a group from Bolzano, and a group of confirmation students.
Gli adolescenti e I giovani di Tricesimo, Leno, Ciupano e Fino Morosco. Chierichetti di Arcene.
Greet altar servers. And the alumni from university, from the Salesian University in Milano, and I wish you all a very happy Sunday, and please do not forget to pray for me. Buon pranzo e arrivederci. Have a good lunch and see you soon.
Bravi.
And we see the Holy Father going back into the Apostolic Palace after giving his Sunday Angelus address, greeting pilgrims and locals alike from Italy and from all over the world, various people who are here on pilgrimage to Rome from different groups, and the Holy Father asking us to pray especially for the victims of the earthquake in Syria and Turkey, as well as the cyclone which has affected many people in New Zealand. And this now ends the weekly Angelus address with Pope Francis in St. Peter's Square on the 7th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Please visit the Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and YouTube accounts for coverage of today's Angelus, as well as other Vatican and world news. We'll be back live again on Wednesday morning from 8:55 a.m. Rome time, when the Pope will give his weekly general audience from the Paul VI Audience Hall. On behalf of Vatican Media, I'd like to thank all of the technicians who made this broadcast possible, and all of you joining us through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks USA, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Radio Maria England, Shalom TV India, Atmadashan TV, Luminous Radio, or indeed via any other online or radio platform around the world. I wish you a very enjoyable rest of your Sunday. Praised be Jesus Christ. Laudato Jesus Christus.